Hey guys, Country Girl 555 here, Tina. I'm just out of the shower and I'm going to weigh in because I feel very bloated, very swollen up, and I have for the past few days now. I've been taking steroids for 2 weeks and I assumed that it would show up on the scale Sunday when I weighed in, but I stayed the same as last week. I've just now weighed and I'm going to pop on the scale and show you what can happen when you take massive amounts of medicine, steroids, when you're in this much pain and everything. I'm not ashamed to do this. Don't be shocked. It's a substantial amount. And you know that I've dealt with this before. I've almost gained this much weight in a single night before. This might blow you away. So let's have a look, okay? There's my scale. Let's slip off my slippers. Slippers to the side. Turn it on. And step on. Settle. 282.2, and that's without holding, that's with holding the camera. When I was on it just now, before this, it weighed 281.2. So we know my camera weighs a pound anyway. But my last weigh-in was 260.2. 20-pound gain. 20 pounds. That's what steroids and medication does for you. And last week I had 18 and a half miles walked. I've not been able to walk any since Friday. So that's Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, 5 days. And I was completely shocked, completely and utterly shocked, on Sunday evening when I did my weigh-in. I did not want to do my weigh-in. I think I posted in my Take It Back group, I'm so upset and so sad, and I feel so bad. I feel horrible that just screw it, I don't want to weigh in. But one of my friends, Candace, she said, get up, go weigh in. And I weighed in. And I weighed in exactly the same as I weighed in last week, which was 260.2. I fully, 100%, expected that scale on Sunday to be a substantial weight gain. And now, Wednesday, it is. So all I gotta do is just keep fighting. This is normal for me, very normal. Very hurtful, very painful. I feel it on my body. I feel it everywhere. My face, my legs, my feet, my hands, my arms, my stomach, and the top part of my stomach. It feels so bloated. I'm gonna turn this off now, and I'm gonna show you a few of the medications that I take. And this is a problem with a lot of people, scared of taking steroids and things like that. And my advice to you is never stop fighting. I go through this. This happens to me several times. The ones that watch me know that this happens to me. It does hurt very badly. And it tries to discourage me. It tries its very best. And I cry about it. But then I get up and I keep going. Because if I didn't, that number would go higher. And it won't come back off. I fought too long and too hard with that weight gain. I was 138 pounds down with that 20-pound gain right there, I am 118 pounds down. I'm not going to lose the ground that I've made, the progress that I've made by losing over 100 pounds. I've worked too long and too hard for it. And I know what I got to do to combat the steroids. I know. And it's so hard. But it's worth every bit, every single bit of it. It is worth it all. I'll let you go now because I'm going to have a really good cry and then I'll come back. All right, guys. God bless. So, yeah, I had a very good cry. And I called my husband into the kitchen. And I said, look. And I weighed in again. And I showed him. And, he's still proud of me. He said it's like climbing up one of those sand dunes down in Porthcawl. You keep going and you keep going. You slide back a little, but you keep going. And I was like, you know, 3 months ago I weighed in at 286 and I worked so hard to get down to 260 and I really wanted to see a 25. And all these stupid medicines, they just, it's never ending. But I have gained ground. And he said to me, you never thought that you'd get below 300. And I did. I fought hard. I never thought I'd get below 250. And I did. I fought hard. And I have seen 253 before. I went back up. But I never stopped fighting. And I never stopped climbing. And I won't let that sand sink me. I won't. I was going to show you guys all the medications, but I've done that before. You guys know. As I was saying, I was going to show you all the medications, but you guys know. If you've watched me, you know all the medications that I have to take. All the illnesses that I have. And, you know, I started out at 398 pounds. I never thought I'd get below 350. And I just kept treading along. So there's no need of me showing you all those medicines. I mean, my stand-up closet right there is full. It's packed full. But I've had my cry now. You know, I didn't think I'd get past 350. And I fought so hard. I stayed at around 310, 315, 320 for about 8, 9, 10 months. And I'd go right at that 300 mark. And I'd go back up to 315, 320. And then I finally, when I seen 298, 299, it was the most wonderful, amazing feeling to know how hard I worked every single day, getting up, trying. And then when I seen the 280s, you know, and when I seen the 270s, and like I said, I remember laying in the hammock in the back garden, and I said, I just wanted to see the 260s, 26 anything. And I want to see 25 anything. And, you know, as I was saying, you know, I weighed in about 3 months ago, and I weighed in at 286, and I fought really, really, really hard to get down to 260, and you know, this is my fourth round of steroids. And the thing I've got to know about myself is how strong I am, because I do feel like I'm in a whirlwind. I feel like I'm going in circles. Sometimes I just think, why can't it be easy? But nothing worth having has ever come to me easy. And I keep praying. And I keep fighting. You know, last summer I was able to play with my granddaughter and roll around on the ground and run after her and lay on the floor and play and talk and do things that I wasn't able to ever do before. So I am gaining ground, and that sand dune, it's not gonna swallow me. My husband says, you know, I watch what you eat. You're always counting your points. You're always making an effort to do something and help somebody else. And even when you're going through this, you're still making an effort to help someone else. And I do. I try. All I know is if I don't show you to keep it real, that you won't know that I know how hard it is. There's so many people I get letters from every day. So many people look up to me. So many people count on me for inspiration, motivation, and courage, and the will and answers. And I don't have them all, but I try, and I'll research anything, and I'll try my best, and I try to lead by example, and I show you the foods that I eat, and I show you that I don't eat junk, and I show you I don't just talk about it. I show you and I show myself that I can walk and work through the pain. But these things happen. And if you let every little thing that happens get you down, and you don't get it out, you don't voice yourself, and you don't have a good cry about it, and you'll keep it bottled up, then it'll only hurt you. And so I've learned my lesson from that. I can't hide that. I have to voice myself. I have to own it. And I do. I always do. I own it. It's me. It's who I am. And I hope that this video helps somebody out there who might be thinking about giving up, because they're going in circles too. And I can tell you, darling, whoever you are, never give up. As long as you've got one more breath inside of you, you've got the will to try. And as I always say, we have hope, and hope is enough. So, today's today. I'm up 20 pounds. Tomorrow when I wake up, it'll be a new day. And I'll keep going, and I'll see how it goes. I will reach my goals. I will. I'm going to have them. I'm going to have these circles. And it's only up to me to fight my way through them. Every single day. Every day. All right, guys. Peace out. That's how we roll. That is indeed how we roll. Even if it's in circles, we still gain ground no matter what. I'll pray for you in hopes that you pray for me. Do something for yourself today so you can do something for someone else tomorrow. Or do something for someone else today so you can do something for yourself tomorrow. God bless, guys.
She's got a lip ring and 5 colors in her hair. Not into fashion, but I love the clothes she wears. Her tattoos always hit her by her underwear. She don't care. Everybody wants to know her name. A house party and she came. Everyone asked me, who the hell is she? That widow with 5 colors in her hair. She's just a loner with her sexy attitude. I'd like to phone her cause she puts me in the mood. The rumor's spreading out, she cooks in the nude. She don't care. She don't care.
Whoa!
Everybody wants to know her name. How does she cope with a newfound fame? Everyone asks me, who the hell is she? That widow with 5 colors in her hair. She was all I thought about, the girl I couldn't live without. Then she went insane. She couldn't take the pain. She said I was to blame. She'd had enough and she'd find colors up. And now she's just a widow with no Everybody wants to know her name. How does she cope with a newfound fame?